that, I don't know what to do here. Oh, then I'm asking you that, speak to somebody, speak to your church, encourage us, move us on, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 It says that I beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and by gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind or be troubled. This is 2,000 almost years ago. Amen. Almost 2,000 years ago. Or be troubled, neither by spirit nor by word, nor by letter as from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand. Let no man deceive you by any means. I'm reading 2 Thessalonians 2, verse 1, and now in verse 2b. Nor by letter as from us, as that day of Christ, and then verse 3. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. Amen.
Amen.
By the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, that means the second coming, called the advent of Christ. His first advent, he came to save us. Amen.
Amen.
And then the second advent, which is his second coming, which he will come in a bodily form, physically, as he left during the ascension. What I mean by ascension is, when Jesus resurrected after 40 days, he literally was taken from the earth to heaven. That is what we call the ascension of Jesus. Amen. The Bible says that he will come in the same manner again. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
This time, not to die for sins, but to judge. Amen.
Yeah.
To rule with a rod of an iron. I need to say something to everybody here. The first, what I want you to know is, every lifestyle you're living, every thought you are processing, every action that you are putting forth every day in church, out church, are not going to be actions and thoughts and lifestyle that will go without accountability. You will give an account.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
If life were to be a life as the atheists and those that do not believe in God, that are naturalists, if there is no God, if there is no accountability, then what would be as Dr. Rabbi Sankarino said, what would be the difference between Mother Teresa and Adolf Hitler? They all just lived. He died, and it's finished. Then you can choose to become a beast, kill everybody on earth, and I can choose to become a saint, live righteous life. At the end of the day, there is no payment, there is no accountability. There's nothing to prove, nothing to be judged of. It's whether you choose to kill or you choose to preserve life. There's no difference. Let me put it in a simple way that everybody will understand. Then the act of coming to community like this, the act of fasting, praying, giving your tithe, giving your offering, showing up on church, prayer meeting, Bible study, and all of those things we do. But if you quantify this action that I'm mentioning here, what I mean by quantify, if you put it in monetary terms, see that the time you spend, if you quantify the time, the money you give, all the kinds of things we do, if we put it in money, it will be a lot of money. Okay? So after we do all of this, if at the end, God, if there is God, if God says, oh, it's nothing, death. We, like Paul will say, we are the most miserable.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I am encouraged to study the last days, the end time, because you cannot study the scriptures that talk about the end time, the coming of the Lord, the tribulation, the rapture, and all of those things without being moved to live for eternity. Amen.
Amen.
You can't. You can't. There's no way you will involve yourself. If I preach to you about prosperity and it will be well with you, you'll be fine, you will be blessed, you'll be big, and you'll be slim, you'll be this, you'll be that. If I preach to you about those things, it will work for you. Because anything you hear, you build your faith on it, and faith, whether it is God kind of faith or whatever kind of faith, works. And so, you have something to show for. But, somebody say but. And so I'm challenging the young people here. I was 22 or 3, if I'm to be precise, when I became very interested about end time. I was a woman evangelist who was an American in Pordenone, and she was very good in end time. So when we speak in church, my heart will be trained. And so I asked a simple prayer for God, if you can help me, I want to understand and teach others. Ladies and gentlemen, this is where I am. Simple prayer can bring a lot of results. And prayer, as Pentecostals have made it, prayer alone doesn't solve problems. When I pray that simple prayer, never open the Bible, never get interested in the past, but talk about Bible prophecy, then time, my prayer has been done, but the answers wouldn't have been done. Because faith without action, there are always a dead faith. Hello? Let the Pentecostal stop making faith a spiritual thing and no actions. I mean,
if you want to
people that can meet university students, many of them are people that don't believe in God. If they can meet them and challenge them, you won't take your number class one room education to talk to those people. Yes. That's why our young people must be encouraged to add God to their knowledge so that they can dig and reach that class of people.
Amen.
So I got involved in it and I studied it. If you don't mind, it's not about me here. I studied. I got a study Bible, big one. At that time, it was too big for over than me. Because this is the family wanted for me free. He said, if you watch me, I love reading. I love studying. So he wanted to give me a study Bible. So he called me, he gave me. It's still in my house. Even yesterday, I opened it. I was doing some reference in it. And by that Bible, my brother, my sister, do a little kindness to somebody in church. Somebody who see a future in him. Invest something small, it will make a great difference.
Amen.
I became a believer, do you know what? Not by a pastor or a deacon. He was an ordinary church member, a woman. But she was a determined woman. She didn't need to be called a deacon, a vitalist, before she would do anything. In our day and time, people want the title first, and then the job. Okay, I will serve in church, but let me become the protocol officer first. See, make me the protocol officer or the chief usher. Then, or put on me the usher thing, and then I'll usher. The devil is a liar. No, you serve first. You give yourself away first. You put your hands in first. This lady taught me all the time, come to me, Richard, come with me to church. She didn't preach. She said, come with me to church. And I keep doing my own thing. I'll come, then I will go, I'll come, then I will go, I'll come. And then, eventually, I don't know what happened. I said, okay, this today I'll go with you.
Yes.
So that you will stop bothering me. And I went. And I will never forget this. Anytime I stand open and I preach, I remember that lady. I don't know where she is. To even go and say, God bless you. I don't even know where she is. Another lesson I'm saying, anytime you do anything for anybody, you want the person to return the glory. And as for this church, we have helped so many people, but the more you help them, they are not in church. Who told you those that you help will be in church? It is not written yet. It is not written yet. The Bible says that Jesus did more miracles than anybody. People followed him in numbers, sometimes over 3,000, 3 million, 10,000, many thousands. But when she was going to die, wow. How many followers did he have?
No.
How many?
Everybody went away.
You understand? And so, was he a big one?
No.
Investment. Those people turned and became the church. And let me tell you, that sister didn't even know that I'm continuing the faith. He just, when we went to church on that Sunday, I was sitting at the back. And they were doing the altar call. She would turn back and look at me. And then I would dodge. She would turn back and look at me. She stood up, came to the back, pulled my legs, and said, go to the altar. Now, in this age, if you do that to a young person,
you're in trouble.
Maybe that young person will say, by his friend, are you mad? Will you allow somebody to pull you? The Bible says, some snap fire. Do the uncomfortable thing. Because what you're doing, you know their soul is at stake. They are living between the thin line of heaven and hell. And so even if they slap you, you want to do whatever you can to
risk it.
I've known people that have been slapped at me. That I want to see them, I want to love them again and again and again. Probably by my love, they will serve the Lord.
Amen.
And now, I'm a pastor, I'm preaching. That sister, I don't know whether she's still a young sister. But let me tell you something, when we go to heaven, everybody expects the pastor to have the best accolades and title from God. God will say, wait a minute, he will show you a video and say, you are this, because I used this sister to make you this. And because of that, she will have a double portion of your award. And you have one. Yes, that's how it's going to be. In case you don't know, it doesn't take titles to be rewarded in heaven. It doesn't. That's why sometimes I tell you, why did you make me a pastor? Because I could do so many things without a title.
Yes, sir. Yes.
And do so little with a title.
Amen. Yes.
As a pastor, you need to walk certain ways.
Yes.
You need to dress certain ways. I rather prefer pulling my shirt out. I rather sit in the church and help somebody.
Yes, sir.
But if you become a pastor,
protocol.
You have to help everybody. Yeah, because people think that you must have title before you can do something. The devil is a liar. You can make a difference. Your life, your words, your being a peacemaker. I sense my spirit, God cannot let me talk about end time. Forgive me. Daddy, forgive me. I will listen to God. And so, ladies and gentlemen, there is an end to whatever we are doing. There is a reward. Amen.
Yeah.
Good one, bad one. As you sit here looking at me, Abel, If you die now, where are you going? Men and women of God, if God call you home now, what accountability are you going to give to him? You have to know that there you can't lie. In fact, you can't even try. Because before you speak, a video of you shows you that will keep your mouth shut. The Bible says in Romans chapter 2, there is not going to be any excuse. That's the meaning. God will make it in such a way that you will not have an excuse. And so I want you to know, in case you think life is the way you want to live it, you can hide, you can dodge, and nobody will see, and you think because nobody sees and nobody knows, God does not know, you are deceiving yourself. We are living in the end time. I believe every reasonable person here knows what things are happening. They are all indications. I want to ask my friend this. When we came here first, see, I've been here for some time. Maybe I won't match you, but I've been here for some time. I've been here 20 something years. Came here very, very young, 21. And I've been here since. When we came here, it was not common to hear that people were seeing visions. And they would see hell. And they would see other things. But in our days, on your WhatsApp, every day, somebody will be panting. Hey, brothers, sisters, change your life, oh, because this night I saw a vision, the devil is a liar. You want to go to heaven with your vision?
Yes.
Vision won't change you. I know a sister, for privacy's sake, I won't mention the name. Had a wonderful vision. Wonderful vision. We told her even to write books. She backslided.
Oh God.
Who said? There are a lot of people saying, I saw this and I heard this. Check their life 1 year or 2 years later. They'll be nowhere. Vision alone can change you. Hello? Nothing will change you by the word of God. I wish you're not sleeping on me.
No.
Nothing will change you by the word of God. That's why when the rich man, he was in torment after death, and he told Father Abraham, see, I have brothers and sisters. I understand that I can't go back. Let me suffer alone. I have brothers and sisters down there who are not saved like me. Please, send one of you from heaven, because I know when you go from here, they will hear. God says it's not a divine law. The divine law says that there are people with them. They must hear them. Amen.
Amen.
Your pastors, of your local church leaders, hear them. You cannot pretend that apostle and doctor, general, bishop, so and so, will be the one that has to speak for you to hear. The divine law says that the people you have with you, you must hear them.
Amen.
But you're doing all your church on WhatsApp. You're doing all your church on Facebook. You're doing all your church. These are end time stuff. These are end time stuff. The Bible says in the book of Daniel that knowledge shall increase. And this is the time. Knowledge. Let me tell you, the technology that people have, it will be a technology for 100 years to come. They already have it. Very soon, man is going to try all he can to create or to make a man, a woman. They have a lot of knowledge. That's why we have the mobile phones. The enemy carefully have made this technology so attractive, convenient, and useful. And at the same time, he has made it so diabolic, so that he can get the people of God on Facebook, on these social media platforms, See, he knows you're a child of God. He knows you won't go and fornicate, probably. But he knows that when he gets you small on Facebook, on WhatsApp, hook up on them, you won't read your Bible anymore.
Yes.
That's it. You won't go to prayer meeting anymore. You won't. People think coming to church for prayer meeting, the Bible says, it's not good enough. They are commandments from God.
Amen.
You can't disobey them and think you'll make it. Amen.
Amen.
So the enemy is now using the social media to now destroy the people of God.
Knowledge shall increase.
Amen.
Amen.
I can tell you maybe 500 things that are happening that should caution every child of God to take stock with your faith and examine yourself whether you are in the faith. Some young people will cry when Jesus appeared and their fathers are gone. They didn't make it. They were so close to the kingdom, yet they missed it. Jesus told the Pharisees, you are so close, okay, but you miss it. And so people come from east, west, and south, and they tend to the kingdom. Watch, you that are very close, you are always in church. You are a church girl, church man, church woman. And the other people, they are street guys. They are drinking and they are doing all kinds of things, but you are a church girl. But how come that a church woman, a church father, a church sister, so is hooked up onto the work system and still come to church every time? Oh God. Why? Either you will belong there or you will belong here. And if you want to belong here, then you have to belong to Jesus.
Amen.
Love what he loves, hate what he hates. Because I need to be sincere and say to you, when Jesus comes, he will start a journey from the household of faith. He started here. People that were not born again but were coming to church, they will receive enough punishment. Serious ones. Didn't the Bible say in Luke that those that know the master's way but didn't do it will receive more. Only few people mentioned it. What about the rest? What were you doing? Didn't you know the Bible? Amen. The fact that you come to church, you come to convention, you come to meetings like this, you're going to receive a lot of punishment if you don't do what the scripture says to you. Hallelujah. My soul is heavy, because in these days it's not like our own. When we first believed, we were dying for Christ. Even here in Europe, I buy a bicycle and motor, and I'll go everywhere to tell people about Jesus. Now, we are prospered. It's even easy to bring people to Europe. You do recongitimento, voila, they are here. Yet when we were suffering at that time, that government, we were serving the Lord. When it is time for church, you want to go. Look at it now. This is because the Bible mentioned a word, and that is the only thing I'm saying on Sunday now. The Bible says Christ will not come until there is a falling away first. What is falling away? We call it apostasy. Falling away is people will be in church, yet they don't belong to God. Falling away, people will go to Bible, they don't even know what is in the Bible. Falling away are people, they'll be singing hallelujah, they'll be so spiritual, speaking even in tongues, yet their heart is far away from Christ. The Bible says in Luke chapter 18, from 1 to 8, he talks about prayer, and then getting to the verse 8, he said, I want the Son of Man come. When he cometh, will he find faith?
Amen.
When he comes, will you be in the faith? Will you be falling away? Now, about 65 are false, or they are led by false leaders. What I mean by false is the fallen away leaders. They are no more in sync with Christ. Yet they say they are called by God. And so they are doing their own thing and saying their own things, saying this to get them popularity, money, saying it to manipulate people psychologically, working on people, because we are living in a time and age where people are attentive only to their needs. You go to a city because you want your need to be met. You travel from one nation to the other because over there, you have heard that when you go get maybe clothes free. People move from one city to the other for their needs. Hello? Consumer-oriented time. You can't be checked for what you will get. You are here because of your issue. Had it not be a problem, you would come. You understand? And so, even as I speak to you, next year I won't find you because you'll be traveling to so maybe Germany or Austria, because now Austria is booming. If you go there, you can 2 years you can take a big money and go back to. In the old time it was not so. If you check the old account in the Bible, any family that moved because of difficulty suffers. We want to remain steadfast with God. When your soul will be fed, when your spirit will be addressed, when your salvation will be talked about, everything is where you want to be. Amen. Because first and foremost, you are a spiritual being. Yes. And then you are a physical being. If you are not taking care of your spirit, but you are taking care of your body, you are spiritually ugly. Physically, you are doing your hair, your nails, you put on new trousers. You shall do this, but your spirit is wearing old garments, old ragged garments. Yet you say hallelujah, hallelujah, falling away. People are deceived. They are not in the faith, but they think they are in the faith. They come to church, they do some stuff about religion, and they think they are. Brothers and sisters, we are living in a dangerous time. You cannot train your soul with this. Amen. Church, we are trading our soul with this. It's better to be jobless and make it to heaven than to make job your God. I must get job home. I need to get job home. Me, I'm our hour, it'd be too much. Hello brother, why are you not to come to church? You don't know what in them I talk. My head will break. Man myself himself will have to try to do some things, some my group, then I will come to church. These are dangerous times. Amen. We will be easily deceived if I come here and start mentioning your name and start doing some things, you believe me. Amen. I'll tell you, I stay in Social Zoo Hotel in Milano. I know you are poor, but do whatever you can. Get you some money from somewhere and come and meet me. I will solve all your problems. The devil is a liar. No man can solve your problem. If God will not help you, who will help you? But they are deceivers, and we love it. But he will send you to hell. They are going there and they want as many to go. Because they are not preaching the gospel. They are not telling you the truth. They are not rebuking you, reproving you, correcting you. They are not telling you the truth. All they want to say is God will bless you. If you are this time, you are this, you are that. But in the Bible, the people were not told in Yama, this only one is maybe one or two. But they know God was with them. Yes. And God is with you. You have it all. Amen. Well, to be honest with you, I came with an entire message. But because of the time, the Spirit of God wants you to talk. Amen. Let's make church a church. Let's stop making church, excuse me, like a social club party. Huh? Let's make church what it is, so that when a sinner comes, he is convinced by the atmosphere, the people. Now a sinner at the gate, there's even two people fighting. And he goes home. Then a brother in church says, it is the pastor's fault. Until God say you are a pastor, never become one. No, I'm just kidding. If God will not say, I'm calling to be a pastor, never become one, you will die. If everything goes well, it's never the pastor. It's all of us. If all things goes bad, it is the pastor. If he doesn't greet you because he was focused on going somewhere, he doesn't like me. Understand? It is we that are making the church of God. But we will pay because he bought the church with his blood. The Bible says that all the monies in this life put together, all the belongings put together, cannot save your soul. Did I say that? Your soul is costly,
precious,
and all the money.
Yes.
Do you believe in yourself?
No.
Are you born again? Are you a child of God? All the money in this life cannot buy you. Cannot purchase your salvation. And so we start from here that we are bought with a price. And so we must glorify God. Not with your body, this body must glorify God the way you live it. Hallelujah.
Yes.
These are the end times. Some of you will meet death before the rapture. And some of you will be alive. As for the rapture, it is imminent. The word imminent means
assuredly.
It is coming. Impending. You understand? And so, biblically speaking, rapture has no signs. You can't say these are signs that show that the rapture is happening. The second coming, which is the physical appearance of Christ to come and judge with all the saints, you see it physically, but the rapture, nobody will see anything. And so the rapture has no signs. The Bible says in this way, if the good man know the hour,
it's
then he would have put all his goods. And so watch and pray. The Bible said many words. I know I'm coming to say them. The Bible said that look for the coming of the Lord. Look. Somebody say look.
Look.
Be a man who has said look. When you are looking for something, you are attentive. You are careful. You are watching. You are looking. The Bible says love is appearing. If you love something, you put all your heart into it. Amen. The Bible says pray for his coming and say Maranatha. Hallelujah. Making church. Making church. They are not praying that prayer. Because they are not ready. Somebody say, Pastor, but me, I don't marry you. The Bible didn't say everybody will marry before he comes. In the days of Noah and Lot, whilst others were marrying and giving marriage and others were single, the gentleman came the same way. Whilst you're single, whilst you're still a university student, whilst still a young boy, a young girl, Christ will come. But when he comes, will you be ready? Are we ready? Amen. You can take the whole word from me. And strip me from being a pastor, be whatever. But don't take Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Don't take Jesus. Sometimes people think that maybe, oh, he's a pastor following, so he has arrived. Who said? Before I was a pastor, I was a child of God. And forever I'll remain a child of God. That's why I can never be offended if you don't call me a pastor. Because before the title pastor and the office pastor, I remember me made in the image of God, a child of God. That's where I am. That's principally where. And then, as time goes on, faithfully God will be adding callings, offices, and other things to you. So, to end it, the falling away, are you in that company? He's my good friend, but ask this question. If he's my good friend, I love him so much. But ask questions. Do you sing? For what? Why do you sing in church? Why do you play the instruments? You have to ask yourself that question. For Christ or for yourself? So that if they don't allow you to sing, you become so upset throughout the week, you can't even breathe. The devil is a liar. If the two of them have teach, and I really have even one to teach, I'll be so happy for them. Yes. The same word. Yes. The same Lord. The same Savior.
Yes.
And so, I'll be the first. I'll have limited responsibility. Because those that teach and preach will be judged strictly. Yes. It's easy to talk.
Yes.
I know be holy sincerely. Easy to talk. You understand? That's why top professors, the things they teach, kills them.
Yes.
Even medical doctors, they teach them, the thing they want people about, kills them. See, you can use education to talk about things, but your spirit and your soul and your body cannot be controlled by education. It can only be controlled when you give your life. Jesus. Falling away. Bible says Christ will not come until there is first falling away. Entire churches will have the cross at their door, big Bibles, thousands of people, but they have fallen away. But when you get that, we don't talk about Jesus. If they will talk about Jesus, they are using his name for miracles. They are using his name to conjure, say all kinds of things. If you look at the modern day church on YouTube and the rest, sometimes you get sick. They are using the name and church as magical right to get what they want to get. Many people are jumping, they are something, they are buying their business for the job they will get, for something they will get. They are not doing the same thing to know him. Now, to know God is equal to have this. As long as you have your job, you have this, then you know him. The devil is a liar. The Bible says godliness is not gain. The fact that you have a good job does not make you a good Christian. God, there are certain principles in life. If you follow them, you can succeed. If you work hard and do this and do that and do that, you can succeed. He's my son. Okay, let's give our hand for him, brothers. This is our prayer secretary. Very, very dynamic. And he will tell you this hard talk in church. No more entertainment. No more. Because if I stand before God, The Bible says, I will give an account of all the nations. What am I going to say to you? Bend down your head. You shall be falling away where you belong. Are you true in faith with Christ? Are you here because of Him? Examine yourself whether you are in the faith. What is your relationship with the Word of God? Do you read it happy? Do you determine that the Word will be your instruction and your wisdom for life? Or you really casually put it down somewhere and go and listen to fables and traditions? Are you among those that are going falling away? Are you the apostates? Are you living on deception? You're deceiving yourself. As long as you go to church, you're fine, or you are not. Please yield your soul, yield your members to Christ. Are you a man of God? Are you tired? Are the people making you miserable? Did you give up last time? Did you slip? Did you backslide? Still maintain your title? Please, you can talk to the Lord. I want to be where you are, feasting at your table, surrounded by your glory, obeying your voice. Give me another chance, Daddy. Help me. This is my prayer. I want to be where you are, dwelling in your presence, feasting at your table, and surrounded by your glory in your presence. That's where said, touch you, and you want to make it right with Christ, you can stand up. Everybody is sitting down, their eyes closed. You came here, but you don't know the Lord. Probably you know Him, but you know Him by sliding. The way He prays no more. Fastens, He can't track Him. There's nothing spiritual that moves you with joy and happiness. Somebody has to force you. Falling away is catching you. Please stand up and let the Lord touch you. He said, Peter, I prayed for you so that when you are strengthened, you will strengthen the other brothers. I do not give you an entire cheap thing. This is hard. But you can give your heart, young boy, young man. You can give your heart to study, show yourself approved to teach, to help others. You can go to university and end up in biblical studies. Do philosophy and other things in order to be able to face this generation who do not know Christ and tell them about Him. But you have the decision to make. You can make it right here. If Jesus comes today, come in this moment, where do you think you will be? Cast off the bitterness, your unforgiveness. Cast off the loggerheads. The past hurts and feelings are very hurting, I know. But Jesus is greater than that. So give it out. Remove it as clothing from you. And let the Lord touch you. Be a new person from this time. So that when you serve, when you be the usher, when you do whatever you do, the motives will be the glory of God, Christ, not you. The Lord bless His church. If you are standing, I pray for you. May the Lord touch you for your sincerity. May the Lord restore you case you're not born again, then after we go on, you can see here, you can see what there is, and we'll talk to you, show you what you ought to do. But in case you have known him, may the Lord touch you on this way. May the Lord remind you that every day of your life can be your rapture. Every day of your life can be the time that the difference can be made. Father, we glorify you. Let all the glory and the honor be yours. Let all the word we are hearing from yesterday, today, transform our lives. Make us indeed the children of God. We thank you.